Hello friends and welcome to Digimento. Today we will be discussing about one nation, one election, one electoral roll. So this is a recent proposal that has come up and this is of so much importance. As an informed citizen of the country, it's very important to know what are the details of this proposal. So let's see what is this proposal, one nation, one election, one electoral roll. So let's move into the details, but before that, if you have not yet subscribed to our channel UGC NTA NET Computer Science, please do subscribe to our channel and also please do press the bell icon so that you will be notified whenever we post a new video. And if you are preparing for GATE, NTA, UGC NET or PGT Computer Science, you can avail our online courses which is available. You can visit our website www.digimento.com or you can call to this number for getting more details about the online courses that we provide. Let's come to the proposal. One nation, one electoral roll. So what is this proposal all about? The Prime Minister's office, which is called the PMO. PMO is the Prime Minister's office. And the PMO earlier this month held a meeting with the representatives of the Election Commission. Now, Election Commission is a constitutional body and the purpose of Election Commission is to conduct fair and free elections in the country. So, elections are the backbone of any democracy and it is through the elections that the people express their feelings or their concerns and their representation in a country towards the formation of the government. So, Election Commission, which is responsible for the fair and free conduct of the elections, we can say is one of the major organs which is responsible for conducting the elections in the country. So, PMO had held a meeting with the representatives of the Election Commission and the Law Ministry. Why Law Ministry? Because Law Ministry is responsible for bringing any amendments or changes to the legal system or to the law existing in the country. This meeting was held in order to discuss the possibility of having a common electoral roll for the elections to Panchayat, Municipality, State Assembly and to the Lok Sabha. Now if we see, these are the various places or these are the various instances where election take place in the country. The Panchayats and the Municipalities, the elections are held and this forms the lowest tier or the grassroots level of the government what we call as the local self-government. Then we have the state assembly and the state assembly can be either an assembly consisting only of the legislative assembly and there are also bicameral legislatures having legislative assembly and legislative council in the state level. And then we have the Lok Sabha. So these are various level of elections taking place in the country. So proposal was or the discussion was to see if there is any possibility of having a common electoral roll. Now before we go into the other details, let me also tell you about this name or this title itself. Now one nation, one electoral roll. Now we know that the government, the central government is actually trying to bring uniformity everywhere. So uniformity everywhere. Now for example, GST, the tagline of GST itself is that one nation, one tax or one common tax. So here we will see that uniformity or a focus has been given on achieving UCC or the Universal Civil Code or the Common Civil Code, okay. What we call as the Uniform Civil Code. So it is even in the constitution it is given as Universal Civil Code or Uniform Civil Code. Uniform Civil Code, UCC or the Uniform Civil Code. Now in many states the voters list for the panchayat and the municipality elections is different from the one used for parliament and assembly elections. So this is the reason or the rationale why there has been a discussion going on to see whether there is a chance of getting one nation, one electoral roll principle done. So the problem is that in many states, the voters list means a list containing all the names of the adult members, that is above the age of 18 years who are eligible for voting. So in many states, the voters list for the panchayat and the municipality elections is different from the one used for parliament and assembly elections. So this means that the voters list is different for elections to the local self-government, and it's different for parliament and assembly elections. Now, election commission is charged with the responsibility of conducting polls to the offices of the president and vice president of India, and to parliament, and to the state assemblies, and to the legislative councils. Now, here we are seeing what is the reason for that. Why there are different electoral rolls or voters list in case of the Lok Sabha elections, in case of Lok Sabha and the state legislative assembly or state assembly. There is a different electoral roll, and in case of local self-government like the municipalities and the panchayats, there is another electoral roll. The reason is that the conduct of elections to the Lok Sabha and to the state legislative assembly or to the legislative councils. So in case of bicameral legislation at the state level, there is two houses. One is state legislative assembly and the other one is state legislative council. So the elections are conducted for the office of president, vice president, to the parliament. Parliament includes both Rajya Sabha and the Lok Sabha. Then the state assemblies, all these are done by the election commission, that is the central election commission. So the election commission, which is popularly known as the election commission. So, election commission means the central level election commission itself. Now, the problem is that the SECs, which is the state election commissions, supervise the municipal and panchayats elections. So, panchayat and municipalities, the election to the panchayats and the municipalities is supervised by the state election commissioners. Each state election commissioners is governed by a separate state act, and they allow the SEC to borrow and use the election commission's voters roll for the local body elections. So SEC, the state election commission, is formed, and the SEC is responsible for conducting the elections to the panchayats and the municipalities, where it is the election commission at the central level who will conduct the election to parliament and the state assemblies. That is why there is a change in the list. Some state commission uses the election commission's voters list as a basis for the preparation and revision of rolls for municipality and panchayats elections. So many state election commissioners, they use the list that is already prepared by the election commission at the state level, and this is used as a basis for preparation and the revision of rolls for municipality and panchayats elections. Currently, all the states except UP, which is Uttar Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Odisha, Assam, Madhya Pradesh, Kerala, Assam, Arunachal Pradesh, Nagaland, and the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir adopt election commission's roles for the local body polls. So, except in these states, all other states uses the same role prepared by the election commission for local body elections as well. Now let's see how this one nation, one election can be, or is one nation, one electoral roll can be implemented. So how this one electoral roll for the entire nation can be implemented? First, it requires a constitutional amendment. Now what is meant by a constitutional amendment? It means that one or more provisions of the constitution needs to be amended or changed. So first, there is a need for a constitutional amendment. So articles 243K to 243ZA, and these articles makes mandatory to have a single electoral roll for all elections in the country. So this has to be amended. Second, makes the state governments to tweak their or change their respective laws to adopt election commission's voters list for municipal and panchayat laws. So we know that the state election commission, who is responsible for the conduct of panchayat and municipality elections, the SEC works according to the rules framed by the state governments. So the state governments also will have to tweak or make changes to the respective laws that they have implemented, and they have to adopt such a rule that the state election commission also uses the same voters list as prepared by the election commission at the central level. So this is how it can be implemented. Now, next one is one nation, one election. Now, we discussed about one nation, one electoral roll. Electoral roll means it's a list of candidates or a list of people who are eligible for voting. All the adult members of that particular place will be mentioned in the electoral roll. So, electoral roll is nothing but it is a list containing the eligible voters of a particular constituency. Now, one election. So, one nation, one election. Now, this is another important plan of the central government to have one nation, one election. We will see that also. So, general elections to the Lok Sabha, which is the lower house of the parliament. So, Lok Sabha and the state assemblies, they are held at a gap of 5 years. So, in every 5 years, we have the Lok Sabha elections and also the state assembly elections happen every 5 years. But it does not happen at the same time. Suppose you belong to a particular state. Your state assembly election, suppose it's going to be now held in 2022. Not necessary that the Lok Sabha elections will also be held at the same time. So, it may be in 2024. So, even though the gap is 5 years, the problem is that the elections to the Lok Sabha and to the state assemblies does not happen at the same tenure or same time, we can say, even though tenure is same. So, one nation, one election means structuring the Indian election cycle in a manner that the elections to Lok Sabha and the state assemblies are synchronized together. So, bringing them together. Suppose the state assembly elections will be held in 2023 or we can say Lok Sabha elections will be held in 2023, then all the other state assembly elections will also be held at the same time. So, synchronizing them. That is the aim of one nation, one election. Now, why there is a difference? The problem is that there were coalition governments. So, because of coalition governments, many times the governments were fallen in the past at the central level and also at the state level. So, this had brought this gap. And simultaneous elections have been conducted for the Lok Sabha and the state assembly simultaneously in India. Now, in 1952, in 1957, 1962 and in 1967, we had conducted simultaneous elections, which means elections to Lok Sabha and elections to the assemblies, the state assemblies were held simultaneously. But this discontinued after 1968-69, after the introduction of coalition era and when the government at the central level and at the state level many times lost the confidence. Now, the advantages of one nation, one election is that it will help in saving money, speedy development work. Also, it will help in check on black money. It will help in the smooth functioning of the government machinery and also bring efficiency of governance. So, when simultaneous elections are held, these are all the advantages. Challenges will be that the local issues will fade out. Then it will be hard time for the regional parties because of all the level elections taking place at the same time, and also it will require huge machinery and resources, and there are certain constitutional problems that constitution needs to be amended for that, and there can also be delay in the election results. So these are the challenges. So, I hope you like this video. If you liked it, please do share it with your friends. And also, please do not forget to subscribe the channel if you haven't. I'll see you again with another video. Thank you for watching.